स्टूडेंट्स, स्टडे आई हैव कंप्लीट द क्वेश्चन नंबर 1 to 6 इन एक्सरसाइज फर्स्ट ए रीजन नंबर. सो टुडे आई विल कंप्लीट दिस लेसन. लुक एट द क्वेश्चन नंबर 7. फिल इन द ब्लैंक्स विद द करेक्ट सिंबल आउट ऑफ लेस देन, इक्वल एंड ग्रेटर देन. सो फर्स्ट यू विल राइट देयर क्वेश्चन. फर्स्ट क्वेश्चन इज -3/7 डॉट डॉट सो ऑन 6/-13 एंड दिस प्लेस यू विल फिल द ग्रेटर, लेस आर इक्वल. सो नाउ वी solve this question. -3/7 is equal to 6/-13, and after this you will cross multiplication of both fractions. So -3 × -13, and after this 7 × 6. When we multiply both negative numbers, after this you will answer is, you will find the answer in positive numbers, because -×- be +. So 13 × 3 = 39, write in the positive form. And after this 7 × 6 = 42. So 39 is less than 42. So -3/7 is less than 6/-13. Look at the second part of this question. Look at this second part. 5/-13 and -35/91. So first you will write 5/-13 and -35/91. Next, in this question 5/-13 and is equal to -35/91. Something different in this question. First you will write the first fraction, 5/-13 is equal to -35/91. Second fraction I will divide by 7 in this fraction, then after you will get the 7 × 5 = 35 and 91 / 7, 13 × 7 = 91. So plus, then you will write the positive 13. And after this 5/-13 is equal to -5/13. Both fractions are negative fraction, so this is equal. Understood, students? Now according to third option, question number part 4th, -2/3 fill 5/-8. After this 2/3 is equal to 5/-8. Now we cross multiplication both fractions. -2 × 8 is equal to 5 × 3. In the question number First, I have told you both negative numbers after multiplication be positive. 2 8 16 and 5 3 15. So, minus 2 upon 3 is greater than 5 upon minus 8. Okay, students. Now we come on the question number 8. Question number 8 says you arrange the following rational number in ascending order. It means the given fraction write in the ascending form. So, first you will write the question 4 upon 9 minus 9 sorry and after this minus 5 upon 12 and after this 7 upon minus 18 and after this minus 2 upon 3. Now we solve this question in ascending order. First you will look at your fractions 4 upon minus 9, minus 5 upon 12, 7 upon minus 18 and minus 2 upon 3. These fractions are different. So first you will these fraction we arrange the denominators according to first you will take the LCM of these denominators, then we take LCM of denominators. Minus 9 upon 12 minus 9, 12 minus 18 and 3. Take the LCM. 2, 9 is the same. 2 6 is 12, 2 9 is 18 and 3 as it. And after this you will solve 2 minus 9, 3 minus 9 and 3. And after this you will solve 2 3 is 9, 3 3 is 9, 3 1 is 3, 3 3 is 9 and 3 1 is 3. And after this 3 1 is 3, 1 as it, 3 1 is 3 and add 1 as it. So LCM is 2 2 is 4, 3 is 12, 3 is 36. So I have solved this question in this corner. The LCM is 9, 12 minus 18 and 3 is equal to 36. Now we first you will write the fraction 4 upon minus 9. We multiply the 4 in numerator and denominator. 4 4 is 16 and 9 4 is 36. Okay, and after this you will write the second fraction 5 upon 12. You will multiply 3 in numerator and denominator. 5 3 is 15, 12 3 is 36. And after this you will write the third fraction 7 upon minus 18. Multiply in 2 in both denominators 7 2 जा 14 18 2 जा 36 एंड आफ्टर दिस लास्ट फ्रैक्शन माइनस 2 अपॉन 3 यू विल मल्टीप्लाई 12 इन न्यूमरेटर एंड डिनोमिनेटर 12 2 जा माइनस 24 एंड 12 3 जा 36 सो आफ्टर दिस you will find the every fraction with the same denominators. So now you will write the fraction, write these fraction according to ascending order. Dear students, first you will write there minus 2 upon 3 because this is the smallest number. So minus 24 upon 36 is less than 4 upon and 16 upon 36 minus 36 and after this you will 15 upon 36 and after this 14 upon minus 36. So the answer is minus 2 upon 3 less than 4 upon minus 9 less than minus 5 upon 12 and less than 7 upon 18. Okay, students, this is your answer. Look at the question number 8. Question number 8. Look at the question number 9. In this question, this fraction write in the descending order. Arrange the following ration number in descending order. Look at this. First, minus 2, comma, minus 13 upon 6, comma, 8 upon minus 3, comma 1 upon 3. Okay, students, first you will write the fraction 2 upon 1 minus 13 upon 6 and 8 upon minus 3 and 1 upon 3. Students, any whole number write in this type minus 2 upon 1. Okay, so first we take the LCM of both denominators. The LCM is 1, 6, minus 3 and 3 is, in the order of word, we take the LCM 6, 3, 3, 2, 3 is 6, 3, 3 and 3, 1, 1, 1. Then LCM is 6. Okay, students, now we take the first fraction 2 upon 1, we multiply 6 in numerator and denominator. 2 6 ja 12 and 6 1 ja 6. And after this, the second fraction, you will write the second fraction 13 upon 6, we multiply by 1 in numerator and denominator, minus 13 upon 6. And after this, 8 upon minus 3 into multiply by 2 in numerator and denominator, 8 2 is 16 and 3 2 is 6, minus 6. And after this, 1 upon 3, you will multiply by 2 in numerators and denominators, 2 1 is 2, 3 2 is 6. Okay, students, now you will get the every fraction with the same denominators. Now, first you will write there the greatest number. Which is the greatest number in this fractions, in these fractions? Look at this. First, 1 upon 3. Why 1 upon 3? 2 upon 6. 2 is the greatest number in this fraction. So, you will write their fraction. Two upon six, and after this, second is number is minus two. Second is minus two. Minus 12 upon 6, and after this, the greatest number is minus 13 upon 6, and after this, smallest number is 16 upon 6, yani ki 8 upon 16 upon minus 6. And after this, you will write their fraction 1 upon 3 greater than minus 2 greater than minus 13 upon 6 greater than 8 upon minus 3. So, this is the answer of nine question. Okay, students. Now, we talking about the last question. These statements, look here. Which of the following statements are true and which are false? Every whole number is a rational number. Every integer is a rational number. And 0 is a whole number, but it is not a rational number. So, look at these answers. First, every whole number is a rational number. Yes, every whole number is a rational number. Then first answer is true. Second answer is true. And third answer is false. Okay, students. So, now the exercise first day completed, and tomorrow I will talking about the exercise first week. Okay, students, have a nice day.